Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you these two journals. I hope you have some coffee, tea or some kind of refreshment. You are sitting down nicely and you are relaxing because this will be probably a long video. Be prepared. I would like to show you everything much more closely than the usual way, like just flipping the pages. And I hope you will enjoy it. I started to use the stamps I had in my drawers for many years, but I didn't use them. If you are on my Instagram, you already saw photos of these two journals. So today I would like to share with you my Gorgeous Girls journal. And it looks like this. I do have tutorial for base of this journal and for like putting journal together, including those Gorgeous Girls, but there is not tutorial how I made those layers with Gorgeous Girls. There is tutorial or on everything else, just not that Gorgeous Girls layout, but I'm explaining in the tutorial kind of, I think, every important things, and I will show you here also those important things which makes me to work with those stamps. And this one was continuing. Here I haven't used Gorgeous Girls. I used beautiful those beautiful images with old cars, with vintage cars, but those backgrounds, they are Gorgeous Girls stamps. That I will show you later. So I'm gonna start with Gorgeous Girls. I chose as a main color this turquoise or mint maybe, and those images, they are from my stuff. They are only on Patreon. I share them with my Patreons. I made them myself to match it all together, because I did colorate my girls myself with my inks and with my pencils and with Sharpies. It's kind of like mix all together. And this is how the cover looks like. I made those covers quite simple. Here I put those eyelets to those corners. I made same on the back cover. Here on back cover I've got small pocket. And here on the front cover I've got this small frame. So some photo can be put in there. And I use those brass corners and same color of eyelets, because this is, I think that is total, not I think, I know that is my total favorite. So when we open this journal, I've got here this opening, and in this journal I didn't use just Gorgeous stamps. I used kind of mix of few different companies. It's Gorgeous Girls from Santoro, then many stamps from Tim Holtz, then stamps from Teresa Collins and Heidi Swap. I think that's all. If I will see some another stamp, I will mention it. So here, I think it's Teresa Collins. I think it's Teresa Collins stamp. yeah, I think so. And when I open it, I've got here, these are, I don't remember these. These are some different company. I don't remember that, but I do have a few stamps mixed here and there. And I've got pocket here, another pocket is here, and pocket here, and one more pocket, it's here behind, between cover and this page, and there I do have this picture. And here with this Gorgeous Girl, I'm gonna go a little bit closer, because I would like to share with you how I felt in love with Gorgeous Girls stamps. Not just with those girls, which are really cute, but with that other stuff I had in that collection always. So what you see around the girl, it was in the pack with her. So there was this label, there was this label behind, and there was also this circle with this girl. And I really love those stamps. I decided to make a layers, so I stamped the image a few times, and then I cut here the frame, and I glue it on that stamped image, which I colored first, and that around frame I used on other image. Just gonna have a look, where is it? There you are. Oh, there you are. And that outside frame, when I cut this inside, the brown frame, so that outside image, I stamped again, full stamp, and then I put that outside image here on the top, so I made this layer. And I really love how it looks like, how beautiful these stamps looks when you make those layers. And I used same technique on those corners, that I stamped first full that image, and then I stamped the corners only 4 times, and I cut out those corners, was like 2 layers, one bigger, one smaller, so I cut out those smaller corners, glued them on the top, and I used lots of a rusty effect in this journal. And here you can see Tim Holtz stamp, and behind that gorgeous gill, I've got pocket, and I've got many questions how I did color it, my girls. So I used pencils. My collections of pencils from Kohinoor, that's company which I know for all my life. They are one of the oldest stationery companies in the world, I think, definitely in the Europe. I had to open Wikipedia because I didn't remember exactly. So they haven't been established in 1790, and it was established by Joseph Hartmuth. He was Austrian inventor, painter, businessman. He did so many things, and he was really good in that. And that company is based in Czech Republic, in my homeland, and that's why I know this company for many since I was small. Since I was not born, but small, because I always use them. They are perfect. They are just wonderful. So I do have my collection here. They are artists' supplies. And I have to say that they are really cool, because they are not too hard. They can be mixed a little bit with water, and they are still working really well. You can make shadow with them. They are just perfect. So I used my pencils from, and I found them on Amazon. That was a big surprise. I found them here in England on Amazon. That was amazing, big surprise for me. That's why I swapped it from those other pencils I had here to Kohinoor, because I know Kohinoor. So I used Kohinoor for coloring the gorgeous girls, and I got many questions how I made that a vintage look on them. So after I colored the girls, I used just distress ink, and with my distress tool I distressed all that like around her, all those edges. So you can see they are a little bit darker. So all edges around her I distress with tea dye distress ink. That was all secret how I made this vintage look. And when I open it, I've got here writing space. Another writing space is here. And I do have here at the front, I've got few large pocket. It's pocket all the way down there. And I've got that this tag, so another space for writing. This journal has really a lot of space for writing. So when we flip it over, we've got pocket here, and I've got there this ephemera and this beautiful picture, and we have mini pocket here with mini tag from my collage sheet, and then embossed piece. Here, beautiful embossed piece, and we can open it. And again, Tim Holtz stamp, Tim Holtz stamp. This I don't remember the name of these stamps. And we can open this one. So it's space for writing here and here. And another gill, I've got on this, and this was quite challenging to color her dress. So I stamped her twice, and I cut out. I need to zoom it. I'm sorry. I need to zoom it. Sorry for that shaking. I need to cut out her dress and color the dress on the side, and then glue that dress on my girl. Because it wasn't easy, you know. She's got here her hands, and I just didn't get there properly. Here you can see another example of a gorgeous girl's stamp, and I made again a layer. I stamped it twice. I cut out that inside that will be somewhere else, and I glued here just that outside frame. And this, that background, those two papers, this blue one or blue one and that top one, this is also, sorry, my camera doesn't zoom, so that blue paper and this white paper with those corners, this is also from Gorgeous Girls stamps. And I do have pocket behind. I've got small pocket here with this tag. I've got my collage paper or collage tag here with this ephemera, and again large pocket all the way down there with another tag. And I think, yeah, I do have pocket here as well. Do I there? I do have there mini tag. That I forgot. So when we open it here, I've got this beautiful girl. Why is my camera doesn't zooming? So we have this gorgeous girl. And as you can see, I've got here again Tim Holtz stamp. These are French stamps, and I forgot the name of that company. Maybe someone from France will know the name of that company. You can write it down. And that frame, again, Gorgeous Girls stamp. And I've got this ephemera inside, my collage tag, and this one. And I've got pocket behind that with this ephemera and another collage tag. And again, pocket all the way down there. So that's here on this page. And here we have this opening and this opening. So you've got writing spot here, some stamping, and this. And it's pocket here. And this one, if you do remember, I'm not gonna open it. I think it's a small surprise. It kind of belonged to those gorgeous girls from my point of view. I'm not gonna open it. That's for a new owner. Like small surprise. So if you do remember this envelope, that's I think 2 years ago I shared on Independence Day the collection with the blue, red, and blue, red, and white color, kind of like mixed small folder. So that it's from there. So another page looks like this. Again, a layering of the stamps. Like this small tag. Here I used Tim Holtz stamp inside. Again, zoom. I'm sorry. And I did fussy cut out even those small hearts. I was so surprised that I don't mind this time. So, and here it's another example. That frame, I'm not sure if you will see that, that oval frame underneath, it's from two layers as well. And I stamp it twice. I cut out that inside. That inside I do have here, like mini tag. And that outside I glued around like a frame. And another, my gorgeous girl. Sorry for zooming. Gorgeous girl. These are dies from LDR. I will put name down below. Beautiful dies. And this is Tim Holtz, that embossing and cutting cutting and embossing folder, that strip. I will try to put names of all the supplies I used down below so you can have a look. I do have pocket here, another pocket it's behind. No, it's from this side, yeah. Good. It's from this side. We will get there. So I've got that this small mini tag and this one. It's in this pocket. And again, a large pocket behind. Then we flip it over. I've got pocket here with Rolodex card, I think it's called, a Rolodex card. And this is from Well Together. This is on my Etsy collection in blue and red. And this is from that collection also. These tags are from that collection, those red ones. So I kind of mix it together. So this Rolodex card, it's from that collection. This I shared just with my Patreons, those ephemeras which I add to this journal. And here I do have small writing spot. Another writing spot I've got here. And here you can see another Tim Holtz stamps I used. These are those faded types or faded fonts. I don't remember the names, but I will try to put everything down below. Here we've got another lady. And as you can see, totally inspired by, you know, Tim Holtz makers, because I love that team. Those creators, those designers are amazing. I always get from them so much inspiration. And they are always using on those paper dolls, on Tim Holtz paper dolls, they are using many times those wings. So inspired by that, this is, by the way, Tim Holtz stamp. This is Tim Holtz stamp. So I really mixed that so many times. So inspired by that, I stamped this butterfly twice. Once I stamp it to the frame and cut it around, and here I stamp it on book page and then color it with, I think, broken china, it was that ink, and I glue it on that girl on the back, on her back. So this is how it looks like. And again, from another that gorgeous collection, these two layers that frame around, and it's pocket behind. And again, large pocket here with another tag, opening tag. And I do, yeah, I do have pocket here as well from this side. That I forgot. When I flip it over, I've got another beautiful girl here. On this side, we have pocket here with photo, another Rolodex card. And opening here and here. So kind of beautiful, nice space for writing. This frame, it's also like shaker card. That first one wasn't, but with this one, it's also like shaker card. And I used inside, there are stars. Inside are stars, and those stars are from here, from that LDR die. I will put name of that die, it's collection of beautiful dies. So I will put the name of those dies down below. I do have pocket in that, in this frame. And I think I forgot to show you one more pocket on that first frame, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I am mistaken. There is just one pocket, okay. That is in that second journal. I've got, again, large pocket over there with an envelope. It's that large full-size pocket. It's there, pocket in this frame, pocket behind that frame. And my beautiful lady here. This is Tim Holtz stamp. This is from stamps. I think it's, who, I don't remember. This is for planners, you know, those mini planners stamps. So it's from that collection. So I really mixed that. And again, I made layer on that frame. And here we've got another lady opening here. If you want to open this one, you have to pull out this one. It's from Gorgeous Girls stamp as well. I mean that circle. This is from French collection. So we have opening again. Rolodex card again. This is just, here is it. Slide it down and you've got nice writing space. Again, Tim Holtz stamp. This is Haiti swap, I think. And that frame around, it's Dogcraft. So I really mixed and matched all kind of my stamps. And I'm happy I am using them here. Embossing folder. This is embossing folder from Daris. I love their embossing folders. And here you can see that inside frame, what I showed you before on that red label here. where I cut out that inside frame. So here is it, place space where I place it, and another gill, and I do cut pocket here, opening, so beautiful space for writing, again a large pocket here, and I do have pocket here, and opening, so there is nice space for writing, and I've got again embossing paper, these vintage adverts, this beautiful, this is picture of library in some university, I forgot the name of that university, but I really like that picture. And we are going to page section, so I made my background papers myself, all those coloring that was made by me. I used that Brayer technique and I stamped many times. I need to zoom it again. I'm sorry, my camera just struggled today. It's like me. I haven't feel good today so much. I think it's something in the air. So, all kind of stamping, stenciling, all kind of coloring. And as you can see, I used so many stamps on these mini tags. They are mostly from Tim Holtz, those teeny text, I think it's called teeny text. So openings and another stamping here, we've got opening here, pocket, here is pocket as well, opening and opening, so there is a lot of space for writing. Here is opening and here is opening. And many pockets, literally many pockets. And we have pocket here, and this is a last one. So this is my gorgeous girls journal, and now I'm gonna move to this I'm gonna call that unisex journal. But I try to make it the way where it will be kind of like unisex, as it's probably more for women. But I tried to keep it kind of like, like unisex. So for the cover, I choose this simple decoration, just small layout. The base I made in a like distressed black color, and it's totally inspired by those old cars. And I did enjoy to make this journal so much. The inside, those basic pages are made exactly same. I just mixed and matched them a little bit different way than it's in that gorgeous girls journal. So you will see that those pockets are more spread between pages. So here at the front we've got again the pocket, and I've got there some ephemeras, and here I used the Tim Holtz. I'm gonna try to zoom it properly. I think my camera struggled today. So here at the front I've got that Tim Holtz paper doll, and I try to, you know, to color it the same way, or to match it same to the tag, sorry, to the same shade of the red color. And I'm using the pocket sleeve behind that lady as a holder for this tag. Another pocket we have here. And again, in this journal, I used mix of stamps. Tim Holtz, Teresa Collins, Tim Holtz. There is mix of another companies with stamps. I think after I saw Marley's channel and her amazing art, you know, while I'm watching her videos, I feel more calm and comfortable with stamps. I'm not perfect yet, but I'm getting there, and it helps me so much to watch Marley because she is awesome with stamps. For her, it's like, it's probably like for me to fold any kind of folds and you know, to put the base of book together. I don't have any kind of, I'm always very comfortable to put the bases together, put the pockets together. But when it comes about stamps, I think I do have heavy hand. That's why I'm not too much comfortable yet. always kind of pushing too much, and then those thumbs are spreading. So when I'm watching Marley, it helps me so much. So after I went there, I went to that. I pull out my stamps and I tried, and I'm so happy I did, because I found how many beautiful stamps I have, which I didn't use too much, and it's so shame. So we've got these two tags. They are like pockets for another ephemeras. I've got here this opening. And again, I made my basic papers with Braille and stamps, and I mix it together. We've got small pocket here, and I do have opening here. And in this journal, I used so many quotes, because I do love quotes, and I was thinking that it will be nice to, you know, to open some page and, hey, here is quote. And maybe at that day, it will make me happy. So I'm gonna zoom. And here you can see I mixed again the gorgeous gills. I think this is from Tim Holtz, that background. Here I do have around the Tim Holtz stamps. I do have pocket here for tags. And in this journal I use those beautiful, beautiful paintings of vintage cars. You can find these images on Pinterest. There is so many of them. And I really love them, so that's why I use them here. I've got this ephemera here, and also this small envelope in the pocket behind. And again, in this journal are full-size pockets. I'm gonna zoom a little bit again. And full-size pocket, and in this journal I made few like collage tags. And I did use those Tim Holtz paper dolls. And this is first one, always one side, it's collage, it is my collage. And for that, it's Tim Holtz team, I mean those designers, also Margaret Miller. I love to watch her, or to go to her blog and to see her amazing collages. They are so gorgeous. And now, more Sediction, I have her... I'm subscribed, or I'm following her on Instagram, and I do love her collages as well. She's awesome. Both of these ladies are amazing with collages. So they are kind of like my inspiration to go there, to try some different styles. So Margaret Miller and Moss Addictions. Probably I'm saying that wrong. I will try to put links for these two Instagrams down below. Go to have a look. If you like, pardon me, if you like collaging, go to have a look. They are amazing. Really amazing. So this is my first tag. And when we flip it over, I've got here this layout. And again, are we zoom? Hopefully yes. Again, I do have some openings like this. And like this, some pockets like this. So lots of mini spaces for writing, and also lots of another pockets for holding. And here is pocket for holding some kind of ephemeras. I've got pocket behind. And here we've got another stamp from Gorgeous Gills, and I did the layer again. I'm gonna go a little bit closer and zoom again. So I did the layer again. And I used quite a lot of rusty effect, because I wanted to card, like pop up that card. In the pocket here, I've got a beautiful, this is postcard. So I've got that beautiful postcard here. Oh, go, go, go. And I've got there also that mini tag. And there is again that large pocket down there. And I do have there... this tag. I'm gonna zoom again just in case my camera it struggled today. So this is my another layer, my another collaging, and I think, yeah, I do have another pocket for this frame, and it's from the opposite side. So this is another page of my unisex journal. We have opening here, we have opening here, so another space for writing. And these are made like a pocket, so something can be slide in there. And I do have small pocket also here. So pocket there, and as you can see, I do have here another quote and another card. So I'm gonna slide that card there. And I've got in this journal more more of Czech ephemeras from my homeland. And we've got this ephemera. And here I do have another that Gorgeous Girls frame stamped. Tim Holtz, Gorgeous Girls. So I'm telling you, I try to mix and match all kind of them. This is Teresa Collins. Or, oh, now I'm not sure. Teresa Collins or Heidi Swap. I think Teresa Collins. So I'm mixing everything. And I think I do have... Do I? Or maybe I'm mistaken that I made two pockets in the frame. Probably I'm mistaken. So we have another that postcard. And here in this pocket, I do have this tag. And I have to say, I really did enjoy it. So when I flip it over, I've got this spread. So another Czech ephemera. And the lifting up, so I can open it this way. I can open it this way. And we have space for writing. We have small, like, slide spot. And we have pocket here. Another quote. Ephemera and ephemera. And here I can open it this way. And we've got beautiful writing spot, writing page. I've got pocket here with another postcard and this ephemera. And when I flip it over, I've got here another layer and post pocket and another of these beautiful cards. I just, you know, when I see these images, I'm sorry for the shaking, I have to zoom it manually and it's just annoying. So when I see these images of those cars, oh, I wish to be at that time where on the roads was just these cars, and I will be like, wow, I want to have that one as well. And all of them, all of these cars you can see in this journal, they are Czech production cars. They are Skoda, Tatra, and I don't remember all those names, but they are from Czech Republic. And I do have pocket here. Again, you can see the Gorgeous Girls, Tim Holtz, Tim Holtz, Gorgeous Girls, Gorgeous Girls, Tim Holtz. I think that frame is Gorgeous Girls. This is Pinterest. I need to point it. I've got here this roll down, like mini tag. And this is opening page. And here I do have also like space for tag, but it's more for writing. And I do have another large tag in this pocket. And I think I just got stuck there. Oh, come on, come on. Oh, yeah. The leg. Oh, the shoe. Here. I'm gonna cut her leg. I don't cut her feet. So this is my another layer on large stack in this pocket. When I flip it over, I've got this layout. So I've got these are circles I shared a long time ago as a freebie. I will try to find the link for that video where I shared those circles, but it's a long time ago. I actually don't remember. I will try to find that link for that video where I shared those mini tags or mini circles. And I do have here again the quote. It can be opened this way, so my small layering, and it can be opened this way. And I do have again pocket with quote with some ephemeras. Is it zoomed? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't notice. So we have opening here. I'm just gonna quickly. And here. just simple and pocket here with quote. Sorry for that, I didn't notice my camera again. Just struggle. And I forgot to mention this one that was in the Gorgeous Girls as well. And if you notice, there was a wish list. And this is actually a Christmas stamp. So there is a wish list. And here, small note like Dear Santa something. I don't remember actually what is there, but there is Dear Santa. So I covered that Dear Santa in that Gorgeous Girls. And I left there that wish list. But here I covered it all. So we've got also Christmas stamp here. And again, Tim Holtz, Gorgeous Girls. Underneath it's that LDR die cut. Tim Holtz, Gorgeous Girls, Gorgeous Girls. So I'm telling you, go to have a look to your stuff. Because mixing all these companies together, it can be so surprising. Like how well they are going together. How amazing way they are working together. All these stamps and washi tapes and pictures. It's just amazing. And I do have pocket behind. Yes, I do have pocket here and pocket behind and that large pocket. I'm talking too much and then I'm forgetting what I should say. So we've got this spread here. I've got opening here, again, small layout, quote and writing space. And I do have pocket here with some ephemeras. And here I do have this layout. Are we zoomed? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't notice. I hope we are all the time. So I've got here this pocket. It's here. And I've got flip it this way. So we have writing spot or writing space. And when I flip it this way, we have these two tags. For writing or for decorating with mini pockets here. And this one I made with leftovers. I put that just acetate piece and I did stamp. This is Haiti swap stamp. These are some French stamps. I don't remember the company. Tim Holtz, Gorgeous Girls, Tim Holtz, Pinterest. And here I've got some ephemeras. That's in this pocket. And it's again opening. And I do have pocket here as well. And when we flip it over, we have this spread. So I've got two tags for writing. I do have opening page. Opening page. And again, mini pockets here. And I do have pocket here. And in that pocket, this is... I think I didn't share this with my Patreons yet. I'm not sure. I start to share my collection of vintage postcards with my Patreons. So there, there are collections... with postcard and some kind of holder. This is one of these. I'm not sure if I already shared this one. I'm really not sure. But I did share already some of them. And I'm gonna continue. So this is small folder. With beautiful vintage postcards. With mini pockets. Tickets and another beautiful vintage postcard, and it's pocket behind for some small notes. So that's this one, and I decorate it again with stamps, and these are, oh, I don't remember the name. I think this is Studio Light stamps. I will have to have a look. If I will find the names, you will have all these names down below or links which I will find. They will be in the description box. So here we have another pocket space for writing. Here we've got another pocket with tag, but this time I try to make that layer on my acetate sheet or or acetate pocket. So this is like a pocket, something can be put inside. And I wanted to try if there is any chance that I can make like double-sided acetate tag. And by that I mean that no matter from which side you will have a look on that acetate tag, you will always see nice spread. So from this side we've got these beautiful ladies with some background, and when you flip it over we've got this one. We've got layer of some quote, ticket and colors which are kind of matching. And I also try to stamp those paper doilies, and I use those Tim Holtz faded fonts to stamp my paper doilies. I should use a little bit darker color, I think it's still bright, but I really like this this look, that no matter from which side I will have a look, you will still see something interesting, no white background. So that's what I was trying to do on this one. It was, you know, to count, to think properly what I wanna see there, but it was lots of fun to create it, I have to say. So that's my gills here, and we have this last page in my journal. So we have pocket here with some ephemeras, and again with a vintage postcard. We've got opening here, mini tuck or mini pocket. We've got opening here, mini pocket here, and two tucks with mini pockets here, which are holding last opening in my journal. So this is my sharing for today. And I do have also a pocket here, which I totally forgot I've got there. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you found some inspiration in those two journals. I have to say, I really enjoyed to make them. I was so surprised how beautiful stamps I do have in my stuff. And kind of I felt like ashamed that I didn't use them, if I do have them, and they do such a gorgeous embellishment in my journals, really beautiful. I'm so surprised with those girls. They do look so cool, very cute, and really so cool in that vintage vibe, because always when I see gorgeous girls, they are kind of like neat, I can't find the right word, like too clean. I'm not sure how to name it, but they're always so cute, but like too clean, I think. I'm not sure the bright word, but in that vintage style, I think they just got another level. So I'm happy I used them. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so, so much for sharing your time with me today. It was quite a long time, so I do appreciate that very much. I hope you found some inspiration. I hope you will try your stuff, you will dig in your drawers and pull out anything you can and try to mix and match it together, because I'm telling you, I'm so happy. All my stamps are going well, really together, going together really well. So thank you so much for visiting me today. Have a beautiful day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.